Today, I'm going to bake for you a really fun dessert. It's called Wacky Cake. It's also called Crazy Cake. There's a lot of different cookbooks that feature this. And while we were on lockdown, my girlfriend Colleen shared this with me because there was a lot of cooking and baking going on. And this is a really easy recipe. So if you're not a baker, you are going to love this little cake. And during World War II, when they were rationing butter and eggs and milk, this was developed so you would still have a decent cake that would rise. And because the baking soda that's in it and the vinegar activates it. So the ingredients are very common, things you're gonna have in your pantry. And let's get going. We are going to make Wacky Cake. For this recipe, you'll need 1 1/4 cup of all-purpose unbleached flour, 1 cup of sugar, 1/3 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder, 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt, 3/4 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 cup of brewed coffee or water, 1/3 cup canola oil, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon of apple cider vinegar, 2 tablespoons of chocolate chips, optional, and 1/4 cup powdered sugar, also optional. Now, because of the oil in the cake, the original recipe says to stir, mix, and do everything in the same pan, and then you don't have to grease it. But I find that it's messy and it still was sticking. So I'm gonna put everything in a bowl, mix it, and then add it to a greased 8x8 pan. So we'll start with the dry ingredients. We have the flour, I'm going to add the sugar, the cocoa powder, baking soda, very important, and the salt. So before we add the wet ingredients, we'll just whisk this together. We'll get all the lumps out. Now I am going to add the wet ingredients. So the canola oil, there you go, very important. You want a neutral oil, you can use grapeseed. Also the vinegar, this is important to activate. You could use red wine too if you don't have apple cider. The vanilla, I saved some coffee that was left over from my pot. This really adds a depth to it. I do it with my brownies too, but you can also use just regular plain water. But if you have extra coffee, this is a good way to use it. See, I still have the grounds on the bottom. And all the other ingredients are optional, and that's for later. I'll discuss that later. So now we just stir this, and what's really nice is you don't even have to bring out the mixer or anything. And just combine this and get a nice, smooth batter. And get all the lumps out. And we will add it to our prepared pan. But look at this. Honestly, this is so easy to whip up. Look at you, you'll be like a scratch baker. Now I preheated the oven to 350 degrees. Now, this wasn't in the original recipe, but since it's been going around, they suggest dropping these in since you're not gonna be frosting this cake. So I got some Ghirardelli chocolate chips and about 2 or 3 teaspoons. Or tablespoons rather. And you just kind of drop them on the top and it really does make a nice presentation. And then we're just gonna bake this 30 to 35 minutes. Start watching it at 30, but I'm not sure how your oven runs. And you definitely wanna check it with a toothpick because you want it to come out clean. So start checking this at 30 minutes. Well, isn't this beautiful? I could hardly wait to eat it. So I let it cool for about 5 minutes, 10 minutes, but it was still warm. So what's nice is if you cut it while it's warm, if you're using the chocolate chips, they're a little gooey and it's just like a little extra treat. So I did use the powdered sugar, but again, that is all optional. And I wanna stress checking your bake time. Usually mine goes to about 35 minutes. And when I did the toothpick, it was pretty soupy. So I had to add another 5 minutes. So just watch your bake time in the center. But this Wacky Cake is really good. I suggest a nice strong cup of coffee, keeping with the dairy-free options. So, let's see how I did. So easy. And ingredients that you have right here in your cupboard. Go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com, and look for this recipe, and you are now going to become a scratch baker. Cheers.